Hello. In just a few days' time, the Northern Hemisphere will get its first glimpse of a new comet. This comet is called C 2011 L4 Panstarrs. Now, the 2011 bit is the year that the comet was discovered, and L4 actually means it's the fourth comet discovered in the first half of June 2011. And Panstarrs is named after the Panstarrs telescope in Hawaii, where the comet was discovered. What I'm going to be answering in this video is where can you see it? What equipment will you need to be able to see it? And what sort of thing will it look like? So when the comet was first discovered in 2011, when you look at what the predicted brightness was, it was actually coming out to be very bright, one of the brightest comets of the last century. Now, in the last few weeks, it did look to be a little bit fainter. It hadn't quite brightened as anticipated, and it would only just be possible to see it with the naked eye. However, in the last few days, it does seem to have brightened a little bit. So we're hoping this should be a fairly easy object to view with the naked eye for a couple of weeks. So between about the 10th of March and sort of towards the end of March, maybe the last week of March, it should hopefully be visible with the naked eye. It won't be an easy object because there are two factors. First of all, it will never get particularly high above the horizon after the sun sets, and the second one, we have an interference from a very bright full moon, which will be coming towards the end of the month. If you have binoculars or a small telescope, then the comet should be visible for at least a couple of months as it moves away from Earth and gradually gets fainter and fainter. So, where should you be trying to look if you want to see it? The comet will never be particularly high above the horizon after the sun sets, so you will need to find a clear western horizon, free from trees, buildings, and all sorts of other stuff. So it's best if you can get a complete clear horizon and preferably away from city lights as well. On the 12th of March, just after the sun sets, keep an eye out to the west, and you'll see a very thin crescent moon. When it's dark enough, you may be able to pick the comet just to the left of the moon, and as it gets darker, it should become more visible. It will, however, get lower towards the horizon as time goes on, so you need to catch it fairly quickly. As we go through March, the comet will appear to move through the constellations of Pegasus and Andromeda, and it will be gradually getting fainter as time goes on. The comet should appear somewhere between west and northwest and fairly low down in the sky. Once we're into April, it is probably going to be too faint to see with the naked eye, so you will need some binoculars or a small telescope to be able to see it. It will continue to get fainter and fainter as it gets further away from the Earth. There is actually an interesting combination between about the 1st and the 5th of April. The comet will actually be very close to the Andromeda Galaxy, which is known as M31, Messier 31. Now, you will need probably a telescope to see it, but that should be some should produce some interesting photographs. So, what will the comet look like? Well, as I said, the comet will not be particularly high after sunset, so we're going to be slightly hampered by bright twilight. But hopefully, we will see a dense nucleus, a coma. And then the tail will be pointing roughly upwards from the horizon. The tail will point away from the sun. This comet has almost certainly never been into the inner solar system before. And once it passes the Sun, indications suggest it will probably be in a 110,000-year orbit. So this is really a once-in-a-lifetime chance to see this particular comet. Now, astronomers are hopeful that at the end of the year we will have an even brighter comet. Now, comets can change rapidly over the course of a few months, a week, or even just a few days. The comet coming at the end of the year will pass very close to the Sun, so it's entirely possible the comet will just boil away, break up, or anything. It may not be quite as good as first predicted, but astronomers are still hopeful. So, thanks for watching, and I hope you manage to see the comet.